Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I will introduce the AnkerMake M5 3D printer for you. The AnkerMake M5 3D printer design is very simple and elegant, and the overall look is very pleasing. The key features of the AnkerMake M5 3D printer include a maximum print speed of 500mm per second, 7x7 points auto leveling, a print volume of 235x235x250, and an AI camera that can detect print errors, monitor remotely in real time, and record the time lapse. The AnkerMake M5 3D printer is already most assembled, so it's really user friendly for 3D printer beginners with no frustrating assembly projects. After unpacking the AnkerMake M5, you will find the main unit, a filament holder, a power cord, screws, a toolbox, a quick start guide in 7 languages, and 150g PLA filament. The installation of the AnkerMake M5 is very easy. You can finish it in 15 minutes, as it only requires you to tighten the screws and plug in a few cables. Before you start using the AnkerMake M5, you need to download the AnkerMake APP for simple device setup, after which you can control printing from your phone. AnkerMake APP has many models for users to choose to print and text. The interface of the app software is very friendly, and there is the remote monitoring function through AI camera. And the panel shows the printing progress, printing speed, temperature, and other important parameters. The whole printing process took 2 hours and 21 minutes. As you can see, the printing quality is quite good. I have no reason to complain. For better print quality, I recommend using AnkerMake Studio desktop software. AnkerMake Studio is also very simple to use. Import the 3D print model file. Select the print speed you want, click to generate a sliced file, and then click print to start printing. The AI camera still allows us to monitor the entire printing process remotely, so we don't have to be at the machine all the time. Under the maximum printing speed of 250 mm per second in the normal mode, the Chinese dragon took a total of 3 hours and 11 minutes to complete the printing. The printing quality is good, but there's a small amount of filamentous residue, but it's okay for me. I also spent about 8 hours printing a large volume ornament, and the result showed that the print quality was very good, and I was satisfied with that. To see how different speed mode affect the print quality, I compared the normal and fast mode to print a benchy. Wait a moment and see how the print quality between these two speed mode. As you can see, the print quality in normal mode is significantly better than in the fast mode, where there is a visible bump on the side of the benchy. But as for me, it is acceptable. Next, I did a clearance test on the AnkerMake M5. I downloaded a file from the internet, especially for clearance testing, and started printing. Clearance testing can know the accuracy of a 3D printer's prints, and in this model, 7 different sets of clearance should be set, from 0.1mm to 0.15mm. When printing in normal mode, the object turns easily with a clearance setting of 0.5mm, and just as easy with a clearance setting of 0.35mm. But when I try to turn it with a clearance setting of 0.3mm, I am unable to turn it anymore. I also try to print a honeycomb cylinder to test the extruder's retraction to see if the AnkerMake M5 keeps printing well after so many iterations of extruder retraction. I was very pleased with the final results, which showed that in a normal speed mode, despite the extruder keeps retracting, it still prints very well with no trace of filament left behind. I then proceeded to zip bending wobble test for the AnkerMake M5 to see how well it would print in the zip direction. The print results show that every layer at the flat surface prints very evenly, but at the corners, it will be a little worse than at the flat surface. But I can live with it, I'm not so hard on everything. The last noise test was done with a decibel meter, and the decibel level fluctuated around 60 decibels at a distance of 50 centimeters from the 3D printers. The noise level is acceptable to me. To be honest, the AnkerMake M5 is indeed a good 3D printer. And given its user-friendliness, it's perfect for 3D printer beginners to buy and use. Based on my experience of using it for a while, I would like to talk about some pros and cons of the AnkerMake M5. Regarding the pros, 1. I really like the design of AnkerMake M5. It truly combines the functions with the art and looks very premium compared to the other 3D printers in the market. 2. The print quality is quite good. 500mm per second print speed is doable, but it is not recommended to use it blindly. You should choose the right print speed in order to print your work with higher quality. 3. AI camera is a great feature. It not only gives the users ability to monitor the printing process remotely and generate a time-lapse video, but also detects printing errors and gives feedbacks to the user at the same time, which is really nice. 4. The screen interface is very user-friendly, simple, and easy to use. There are not too many function buttons to confuse the user, which is really friendly, especially for beginners. Regarding the cons, 1. The one thing I can think of to improve is the functionality of AnkerMake Studio, especially the generation support. Currently, it requires the user to manually purchase the support. It would be nice if in the future it could be updated to automatically generate the supports for the user. 2. The first time you use it, you have to download the AnkerMake app to connect and configure the printer on your phone before you can connect wirelessly. And I think it should be also supported laptops for the first connection and configuration. Okay, that's all for AnkerMake M5 3D printer. Thank you for watching. You can follow my channel if you like it. See you next time.